Hi everyone! Today I'll show you how to make a repeat pattern using the free image editing software GIMP. In last week's video I drew this amaryllis Christmas flower, and in this video we'll continue by scanning it, editing it and turning it into a seamlessly repeating pattern for print-on-demand sites like Society6 and Redbubble. There'll be a timestamp below to where different parts of the image editing, pattern making and uploading to POD sites start if you want to skip to a specific part. So, once the drawing was finished, I scanned it in 600 dpi resolution, but try to use at least 300 dpi. Or, if you're taking a photo instead of scanning, I would use one of the largest size settings available and take the photo in natural light in front of a window or outside, but not in direct sunlight. Preparing for the repeat pattern design, I edited the image in GIMP, which is a free image editing software you can download on desktop. The version of GIMP I'm using at the moment is 2.10.12, so if you're using something else than 2.10, it might work or look a bit different. The first thing I usually do is adjust the white and black levels. So go to Colors, Levels and click on the white eyedropper and then on the part of the image that should be white, and vice versa, click on the part you want to be the darkest using the black eyedropper. I don't typically use the gray eyedropper in the middle. You can select the split view so you'll see a side by side of after and before. And then I add sharpness at filters, enhance, sharpness, unsharp mask. You can try adjusting the radius and amount. In this case, I also adjusted the black levels from exposure to make the shading on the pencil drawing a bit darker. So go to Colors and Exposure to adjust that. The most time-consuming part is removing the background. First, add an alpha layer by going to Layer and Transparency and click to add an alpha layer if it isn't already grayed out. If your background is very even colored, you can select it by using the fuzzy select tool that will select a continuous area of the same color, or the select by color tool that selects every area of that color within the image. Change the threshold if the tool selects too much or too little of the color area. Press Ctrl and X to delete the background, and press Ctrl C or Z to undo it. For my drawing, I can't get a clean cut with these tools, so I'll use the free select tool to draw the outlines of the flower to make sure I get a clean outcome. You can do it in sections by selecting and deleting parts of the background at a time. If your outline is very complicated, it's going to take a long time, but the result will be much better since you won't end up with any stray pixels when you go through the image by hand like this. If you mess up, you can just move the selection point where it needs to go. Alternatively, you could use the eraser tool, but in my opinion, that's more likely to leave stray pixels behind. To make sure that I've gotten all the background out, I add a new layer, move it under the drawing and turn it black since the background I cut was white, and I'll be able to see on the black whether there's any white left where there shouldn't be. Next comes the repeat pattern making. If you're uploading to Redbubble and you just want the same image to repeat, you don't need to do anything more. Redbubble has a tiling tool that will repeat the image either diagonally with an offset grid or just with a regular grid. However, we can make it a little more interesting than that by adding two versions of the same image into the pattern. To fit two images into a repeating unit, let's make the background a bit bigger. The image size you have now depends on the size of the original artwork you scanned and the resolution you used for scanning. You can see the size in the toolbar on top. Mine is about 3400 by 4400 pixels, so I'll use 6000 by 6000 pixels for the new image, which is a bit big though. There'll be lots of space between the flowers. Create a new, bigger image with a transparent background by going to File, New, and set the image size and turn the background transparent from the advanced options. Drag the image you edited on top of it and merge the layer down by right-clicking on it and choosing the option from the drop-down menu, so that it's all just one layer. Then go to Layer, Transform, Offset, and click on the first button to offset by both width and height. Now you have an empty space in the middle. Drag the previous image over again, and now you can alter it slightly to add some variation to the pattern. So you could use the flip tool to make a mirror image. When you're done, merge down the layer again, and this is the repeat unit. Export this image as PNG, and you can upload it to Redbubble as is and use the regular grid tool to turn it into a repeating pattern. For other print-on-demand sites, you'll need to tile the image in GIMP. For Society6, for example, I like to make an image of 12,000 by 12,000 pixels because it's big enough for most of the products. Make sure the layers are merged so you're not trying to tile just one of the layers. Go to Filters, Map and Tile, and enter the size of the image you want to make in pixels and click OK. You can also use the Rotate tool to tilt the second image a bit. Remember to separate the layers first with the Undo button though. Or you can turn it fully upside down. You can also turn it into a silhouette by selecting the empty background and inverting the selection by going to Select, Invert, and then choose a color you want and fill the image into a colored silhouette by going to Edit and fill with foreground or background color. You can export this as PNG if you want to keep the transparent background, but for Society6, JPG is fine for most products, so I'll use that. You can add a new layer for the background color, but if you don't do that, the background color for the image will be the active background color you have chosen in GIMP. I sometimes have an issue with uploading PNG files to Redbubble with a transparent background made with GIMP, so I tend to open them in another image editor like Paint 3D that comes with Windows 10 and just save a new version of it and use that for Redbubble. I'm not sure why it happens, it isn't a problem every time, and I haven't figured out yet which type of images create the problem and which ones don't. When you upload the tiled image to Society6, it shows up on all products they currently have as I'm filming this, except for the duffel bag, which needs a bigger image, about 15,000 by 12,000 pixels. I would then go and change up a few of these, like the sticker and the t-shirts and tops, to just the PNG image with a transparent background of one flower on its own. And then I'd position the pattern better on some of the product types. This pattern is quite sparse and the flowers are really big, so you could, depending on the original size of the artwork, scale down the image before making the pattern or tile a bigger image and scale it down on the products. In Redbubble, you can upload the repeat unit we made as a PNG and then go to each product where the tiling option is available, like the all-over print shirts, and use the regular grid repeat option and size the pattern how you want it. And again, change another file for the sticker and the normal t-shirts, and so on. If you want to know more about uploading your art to POD sites, click on the playlist on the screen. Thanks for watching! Bye!